Hey guys, welcome back to World Mechanics. Thank you guys for watching and subscribing to the channel. Today will be super helpful for you guys to any of you having a Kia Optima. Let's say you guys have a Kia Optima. You want to know how to remove or replace upstream oxygen sensor. This is also known as bank one, sensor one. Stay with us, we will explain how to do that, everything from start to finish. And we will also explain how you can test those sensors, guys. So make sure you stay until the end. Very helpful information will be shared with you today. In addition, we will even share information about which computer we use for diagnostics, because many of you guys request that information in the comment section below. This should actually work, guys, on Kia Optima generation 2010 to year 2016. Now, if you guys want to see where we buy all the tools, parts, anything that you need for your Kia Optima, check out the link in the description of the video below, guys. We'll share everything, guys, there. Also, you can see where we get all our tools and parts from for a really good price and quick shipping as well. Something else, guys. Every single car we get at the garage, we try to make at least 200 to 300 free repair videos. We take them completely apart. We show you how to fix pretty much anything. And that's the plan on that Kia Optima as well. All the mechanical videos will be on this channel, and if you want to see videos about diagnostics, electronics, fixing electronic components, guys, all that will be shared on our second channel. It's called Electrical Car Repair Live, so check it out, it will be there. Now let's go ahead, continue, and show you what we need to do. So this specifically, guys, it's a 2013 Kia Optima that we'll be working on. So let's explain what we need to do. We are going to remove the upper engine cover. Okay, that's what it is right here, guys. First, okay, let's go ahead. We're going to show you how to remove the upstream oxygen sensor, where it's located. Then we'll explain what computer we use for diagnostics. And third, we'll explain, guys, how we can test these sensors. Now, with that being said, this is the engine, 2.4 engine, GDI engine. This is the intake manifold. On the backside of your engine, you will have your exhaust manifold, guys. That's where the exhaust for your Kia vehicle is located. And that sensor down there, all the way down there, guys, okay, you can see. That sensor, that's the one, okay, known as upstream oxygen sensor or bank one, sensor one. And if we, okay, let me just get in a comfortable position. If we come up to here, okay, we're going to find the connector, okay, right there. We'll pull it out, we'll grab it. There is one thing that we push, okay, right there on the side, and disconnect it. Now, the cable, okay, you have one holder that is holding that cable in place right here. Okay, this one is a little bit loose. You need to make sure you tighten it later so it keeps the new sensor in place and it doesn't fall, because if that cable touches the exhaust, it will melt, guys. Now, let's explain what we need to use, guys. That will make your life so much easier. That right here, it's a special socket for removing oxygen sensors. Without that thing, you have really hard time, guys. We'll put the link in the description of the video below to see where we can get one from. So, I'll just go ahead, watch how it goes through the wires. I'll go like that and install it on the oxygen sensor. Okay. Now, I'll get a ratchet. Okay, perfect. I'm just gonna, okay, zoom in a little bit right here. I'll move that cable out of the way so you can see the action. Okay, perfect. And that thing will be super, super tight, guys. Tight to the point that you, okay, what I usually do, okay, let me show you. I get an extension with a socket, guys, okay. And trying to remove that thing without smashing my hand. Okay, it came loose. It comes loose all of a sudden, guys. Okay, let me see now. Yep, it's loose. Now, I'll go ahead, pull it out. Let me explain what we're going to do. Okay, you can see where that thing is. I'll remove the socket. Socket came out. Now, the sensor itself, guys. Okay, I'm going to go all the way down there. And we're going to start. Okay, let me see how I can reach that thing. Turning that sensor. Okay, you have to turn the cables at the same time. Little bit limited room, guys. We're trying our best to get the camera in here, light and everything, so you can see. Never do that on hot exhaust, you severely burn yourself. And that's the upstream oxygen sensor out of that Kia Optima, guys. Now, this is what it looks like. Let's explain now, guys. This is the computer that we use for diagnostics. That tool is simply amazing, guys, due to the fact that it works on almost any car you can think of. And Kia, okay, is right here. You can access every computer in your Kia, read codes, delete codes, and see live data, which makes it super powerful too. And it can pay itself off in one time use. We'll put the link in the description of the video below. For instance, this Kia Optima has 17 computers, guys. Imagine how many some newer vehicles have. Way more than that. Some Mercedes and BMWs, we've seen up to 55. Now that's the sensor, guys. If you want to see how to test oxygen sensor or find out if the oxygen sensor is good or bad, we have a special video on the channel that's going to explain how to do that. So please, guys, check it out. Hopefully the video will be helpful to any of you trying to figure this thing out. Thank you for watching and see you guys next time.